Settle down, G.I., settle down. And now I've got a million-dollar proposition for you. If there's anything worse than fighting a war on Christmas Eve, it's gotta be our final act. Their jokes are lousy, but their dancing's even worse. Here they are, Captain Bob Wallace and Private Phil Davis.
Private Davis.
Yes, Captain Wallace?
Remember, don't sing until you see the whites of their eyes.
I see them.
Well, then sing!
Happy holidays. Happy holidays. While the merry bells keep ringing, may your every wish come true. Happy holidays. Happy holidays. May the calendar keep bringing happy holidays to you.
Say, that's quite a crowd we've got out there. What do you think?
Well, it looks like they've been through a war.
They have been through a war.
Well, then they look pretty good.
While the merry bells keep ringing, may your every wish come true.
Captain Wallace?
Yes, Private Davis?
Do you know how long it's been since I've seen a girl?
Ooh, how long is that, Private?
I don't know, but we're dancing awful close.
May the calendar keep ringing happy holidays, happy holidays to you.
All right, all right. We've certainly had a good time tonight, haven't we, fellas?
Yeah.
Look, I know you're all missing home. So here's one to put you right back in front of that fireplace, sung by our very own Captain Bob Wallace.
I'm dreaming of a white Christmas, just like the ones I used to know, where the treetops listen and children listen to hear sleigh bells in the snow. I'm dreaming of a white Christmas with every Christmas card I write.
Come on, boys, help me out.
May your days be merry and bright, and may all your Christmases be white.
Attention!
What the devil is going on here? Don't you men know there's a war on?
Yes, sir, but it's Christmas Eve, sir.
Attention! And... take off that ridiculous hat.
Yes, sir. Just a little Yuletide cheer, you know, Santa Claus and so on.
Davis, if you could march as well as you jingle, this war would be over.
Yes, sir.
Captain Wallace, I believe you're out of uniform.
Yes, sir.
Dismissed?
Yes, sir. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
And gentlemen, thank you for a fine show.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Merry Christmas, sir.
So, Christmas Eve, 1944. I don't see any flying reindeer in this little corner of the world tonight. Gentlemen, I have some news for you. As of 0100 hours, I've been called back stateside to get this German buckshot taken out of my leg. And if you don't give the new CO as much as you gave Henry Waverly, I may come back and fight for the enemy. It has been my great privilege to lead you men. Johnson, Sanchez, Pirelli, the 151st Division is doing America proud. maybe in a year, we'll be celebrating the holidays around a fire with our families and friends. In 10 years, 1954, who knows where we'll be. Let's pray it's a better world. Soldiers, Merry Christmas.
Welcome back to the Ed Sullivan Show, brought to you by the 1954 Lincoln Mercury and Oxalt Detergent, washing them that all-American purity. Use Oxidol
for purity!
And now, America's favorite song and dance team, recording artists and Broadway stars, Bob Wallace and Phil Davis.
Happy holidays, happy holidays. While the merry bells keep ringing, may your every wish come true. Happy holidays,
happy holidays,
happy holidays,
happy holidays.
May the calendar keep ringing. Happy holidays to you.
Let the dance floor feel your better. Step as lightly as a feather. Let yourself go. Come, hit the timber. Loosen up and start to linger.
Can't you hear that cock-a-rimba?
Let yourself go. Let yourself go. Relax and let yourself go. Relax, you got yourself tied up in a knot. The night is cold, but the music's hot, so come on, cuddle closer. Don't you dare to answer no, sir. Put your banker looking grocer. Let yourself go. Let yourself go. Relax and let yourself go. Relax, you got yourself tied up in a knot. The night is cold, but the music's hot, so come, cuddle closer. Don't you dare to answer no, sir. Put your banker, clerk, and grocer. Let yourself go. Relax and let yourself go.
Relax,
relax. You got yourself tied up in a knot.
Yeah.
The night is cold, but the music's hot.
Hot.
The night is cold, but the music's hot.
Hot.
The night is cold.
Hot.
Happy holiday. Happy holiday. While the merry bells keep ringing, may the calendar keep ringing. Happy holiday.
Happy holiday.
Try our new show.
We'll see you in Florida. Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas.
was a great show, Mr. Wallace.
Thanks, Tess. Hey, would you tell Scooter to pick up the tempo on that second dance break? And you, I thought I told you to work on the second chorus, not the second chorus girl.
Guilty as charged.
Hey, telegram, telegram, and signature.
Have you secured the tickets for the train tonight?
Yes, sir. You and Mr. Davis have a drawing room on the 1 a.m. to Miami.
Good.
The kids in the chorus follow you down in 2 days for rehearsals.
Great. Thanks, Tess.
Christmas in Florida. I like that.
18 holes and a swim in the sunshine. You want to move there.
Hey, hey, the 151st comes through again. Captain Wallace, Private Davis.
Corporal Sheldrake. Gee, I wish I was back in the army. Da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da. Hey, you think all TV producers got started by finagling black market nylons?
This one did, boys, and I've got a $1 million proposition for you. Ed wants you back on the show after the Florida tryout. You do a piece on your new review, and we broadcast it. What do you say?
What do you say, Bob?
It's a $1 million proposition.
Great, I'll send you all the bump, and hey, have a Merry Christmas, fellas.
Merry Christmas, Ralph.
Merry Christmas.
Oh, Billy Dillio. Once we're in Florida, are we gonna work on that new quote-unquote routine, unquote?
Oh, yeah, honey, yeah. I got it all worked out.
That last routine did wonders for my sacroiliac. Hiya, Bobby! See you in Florida!
Oh, and remember, use Oxidol
for purity!
Oh, Philly Dilly!
Have you ever considered giving the female sex a, breather?
What? And give up show business?
I don't know what's getting older faster, me or your jokes.
Hey, tell you what, why don't we go grab a drink tonight before the train? I heard about this great little club downtown.
Whoa, 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 whoa. I smell an angle. Skip the scan, Phil. What do you really want from me?
Okay, you remember Mess Sergeant Frankie Haynes?
Freckle-faced Haynes, the dog-faced boy?
Yeah, his sisters are doing a show in some joint. We said we wanted a sister act.
Now, this isn't some plot to hook me up with some belly dancing rocket scientist.
So way to find a sister act. Of course, we could always take Rita and Rhoda along.
Will you just stop? You know, ever since we were in the Army, you've been trying to hook me up with something female. 10 years now,
Bob.
Let me finish. Big ones, little ones, dumpy ones. As long as it's squaring a skirt and still breathing, you trot it out.
I'm trying to put a little romance in your life. I want you to go out and have some fun. Remember fun? I want you to stop being Bob Wallace Incorporated and fall in love. Then you can get married and have 9 children, so you'll have a home and I can go out and get a massage or something.
Well, maybe you've got a point about family, but come on, Phil. Most of the gals we meet, they're young, they're ambitious. They don't want to settle down and raise a family. And as for love, no thanks. Too much like, the weather.
You lost me.
Unpredictable, irresponsible, unbelievable, unreliable, ever since the world began, our Cupid and the weatherman. Love and the weather, always together, can't be depended upon. One day it's sunny, next day the sunshine is gone. Love and the weather, always together, planning another surprise. Bringing the raindrops just like the tears to your eyes. Any guy that love goes by is cozy and warm. Love walks up and kicks a guy right out in the warm into a storm. Moonlight romances have to take chances. That's what you learn when they go. Love in the weather can't be depended upon.
I told Jimmy to put them at the table right down front. I'm so excited. Hope I don't stare at them during the number.
I still don't understand it.
Oh, Betty, would you settle down? We've actually got Wallace and Davis coming to see us.
Yes, but how did Wallace and Davis ever find out about Betty and Judy Haynes?
They're in the Army with Frankie. Maybe through Frankie.
Frankie's in Alaska. How did he ever get to Wallace and Davis? I smell a rat here. And the same rat who told the club owners we were his cousins.
I didn't say cousins. I said we went to kindergarten together.
Haven't you ever heard about honesty being the best policy?
Yes, and I never believed it for a second. Don't you want to get someplace, Betty? Do you want to keep playing dives like this forever?
Oh, honey, I do want you to succeed.
We're a twosome, remember? I don't succeed if you don't.
But Judy, I don't want you to hold the act together because of me. If you get a great offer, if you meet a really great guy,
how could you be so beautiful and so insecure? You're the one who deserves the offer and the guy.
I don't know about deserve him, but I'm gonna grab my umbrella and put on my galoshes when I meet him.
You lost me.
Love in the weather, birds of a feather, can't be depended upon. One day it's sunny, next day the sunshine is gone. Love in the weather, always together, planning another surprise. Bringing the raindrops, just like the tears to your eyes. Any gal who's Cupid's pal is cozy and warm. Love walks out and kicks a gal right out of the morn. Into a storm, moonlight offenses, have to take chances. That's what you learn with the dawn. Love in the weather can't be depended upon.
Look, Bob, just humor me, will ya? We'll go see Frankie's freckle-faced sisters, and maybe the skies will clear, the weather will break, and the love of your life will pop out of a puddle. I'll go catch us a cab.
Guy with love goes by, it's cozy and warm.
Love walks out and picks a gal right out of the morn.
Into a storm.
Love's golden chances, rain comes along and then gone. Love in the weather, change from night to dawn.
Unpredictable,
irresponsible,
unbelievable,
unreliable.
Love in the weather cannot be depended upon.
I don't know how to smoke, but you could teach me.
Hiya, Philly!
Funny about baby, you here?
Ho, ho, ho! Merry almost Christmas, and welcome to the back room at Jimmy's, who is now proud to introduce Betty and Joni.
Judy.
Judy, the Baines sisters. The Haynes sisters!
Sisters, sisters, there were never such devoted sisters. Never had to have a chaperone, no sir. I'm there to keep my eye on her. Caring, sharing, every little thing that we are wearing. When a certain gentleman arrived from Rome, she wore the dress and I stayed home. All kinds of weather, we stick together, the same in the rain or sun. Two different faces. differences, but in tight places, we think and we act as one.
Uh-huh.
Those who've seen us know that not a thing can come between us. Many men have tried to split us up, but no one can. Lord help the mister who comes between me and my sister. And Lord help the sister who comes between me and my man. Sister, ever loving sister. Sister, don't come between me and my man.
Let's hear it for the Haynes sisters. I think these kids are going someplace.
Wow, these girls are terrific. We could throw that number right into our new review.
Well, I'll tell you one thing. They sure don't take after Freckle-Face Haynes the dog-face boy.
Especially the one. Yikes.
Yeah, that blue-eyed is a real knockout.
Well, I was talking about the green-eyed, but... partner, this is why you and me are partners.
Now, a girl like that's probably got a whole string of guys attached. She's probably married.
Well, why don't you find out in some roundabout way? Talk to her, Bob.
Phil? What do you mean, talk to her?
They'll be here in a second. I invited them for a drink.
Are you what?
You think I'm sitting here so I can see more of you?
What am I supposed to do?
Well, I won't say be yourself, so why don't you try to be relaxed? Be natural.
Be natural.
A couple of casual questions and a look, here they come. Natural, Bob.
Natural.
Wait, do I look okay? You're gorgeous. Now relax. Talk to them, Betty. Be natural. Natural.
That was a great number.
A fantastic number.
How do you do? My name is Judy Haynes, and this is my sister, Betty.
Oh, Wallace Davis? Davis Wallace.
Oh, we know who you are.
Well, sit down, sit down. Have some champagne. Come on, Bob. Don't be shy. The formal type. Well, here's looking at you.
Cheers.
Are you married, Miss Haynes?
You know, Bob and I are doing a new review. You two would fit right in if you could make a Wednesday rehearsal in Miami.
Actually, I happen to be single without any children, which is to say, I have no children to speak of. It was
Maybe we better get down.
So, rehearsal in Miami?
Oh, too bad we've got a train of our own tonight. We're booked for the holidays in Pine Tree, Vermont.
Vermont? Where's that? And what's there besides good-looking girls?
A lot of snow.
You know, Frankie wrote us a terrific letter about you.
Oh, so that's how you found out about us. And isn't that funny? Frankie has exactly the same handwriting as Judy, even the little faces in the O's.
Oh, it's just a family resemblance.
Yes, the rat side of the family.
You're kidding. You mean I got taken and I didn't even see it?
Mr. Davis, I am so sorry.
Sorry? You were brilliant. Care to dance?
We have a train, Judy. Oh, shut. The formal type. Mr. Wallace, I apologize for my sister.
Well, Judy didn't do anything wrong. She saw an angle and she worked it.
An angle?
Why, sure, she played the percentage and got what she wanted.
Percentages and angles, isn't that pretty cynical?
Oh, come now, Miss Haynes. There's a little bit of larceny in all of us.
My sister and I do not play angles.
Well, then, what was that phony letter, if not an angle? Excuse me, do you mind if I just enjoy my drink?
Please do. Just make sure you sip it from the right angle. Well, would you look at that? They're crazy about each other.
You know, maybe Bob and I should come up to Vermont. Join you two on that train tonight.
But Bob doesn't want to go to Vermont.
Well, we won't tell him he's going there.
Oh, it should be beautiful up there. All that snow.
It can't be half as beautiful as this.
The best things happen while you're dancing. Things that you would not do at home come naturally on the floor. For dancing soon becomes romancing. When you hold a girl in your arms that you've never held before. Even guys with two left feet come out alright if the girl is sweet. If by chance their cheeks should meet while dancing, proving that the best things happen while you dance.
How are you two doing?
Good.
Terrific.
Great.
Fine.
Well, we better get hoofing, partner, if we're gonna catch that train tonight.
Yes, us too.
Tell you what, Bob. I'll pick up the tickets and meet you at Grand Central. Don't you worry about a thing. I'll make all the arrangements.
You're suddenly eager.
Hey, we've got work to do. Remember work?
Oh, Mr. Davis, it was a pleasure. And I hope we meet again very, very soon.
Miss Haynes?
Mr. Wallace, I would wish you a Merry Christmas, but you probably don't believe in Christmas.
Ha!
Are you sure you still want to go through with this?
Are you kidding? We've got to get those two together.
But won't Bob be angry going to Vermont when he thinks he's headed to Miami?
I'll take care of Bob. Track 22?
Track 22.
In Florida? Dream on, pal.
Well, I don't get it. Tessie said she books us a drawing room to Miami, did she not? A private bar, two soft beds, and a bathroom closer than 10 cars away.
Must have been some kind of snafu with the tickets.
Providence! Providence!
This is like traveling in a ration can with Rip Van Winkle. Say, aren't these people wearing pretty heavy coats for Florida?
Well, these trains are always cold. Aren't you freezing? I'm going to complain to the company.
Providence!
Oh, you're gonna bully them, mate. Wait a second, did that guy just say Providence?
What? Providence? Oh, he meant Providence, Virginia. It's an old revolutionary town. I think Jefferson came from there. And when it's dry and ready, my dreidel I shall play. Mazel tov.
Hey, Phil. Sit down. Keep thinking about those two poor girls on their way to Vermont.
Oh, man.
And Ian, in Vermont.
It could be beautiful up there, all that snow.
Yeah, playing old Grisnell with some chintz curtains.
I am very fond of chintz myself.
You know what? I bet they have an old barn out back where they put on their pathetic little shows.
Bob, you are psychic.
Oh, hey, you guys. Funny running into you here.
Oh, no, 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 no!
Mr. Wallace, I'm very sorry. I really didn't know about it until just this minute.
So you don't play angles, huh? Shut up!
Well, I never.
This is not an angle. At least it's not my angle. It's my sister's, and I'm very ashamed.
Well, you ought to be ashamed. Following us all the way to Florida like this.
Providence, Rhode Island. Arriving
Providence. I should have known. It's being shanghaied back to New Haven, Delaware.
Well, you might as well settle in, buddy. Just think of it. Vermont. The pine trees, the clean cold air, brr. Just what we need to wake us up.
Sure, the snow-covered slopes, skiing and shushing.
Steaming hot cocoa.
It's true, Mr. Wallace. It's very beautiful up there.
Beautiful? It'll be a winter wonderland.
Snow!
Snow!
Snow! Snow! It won't be long before we'll all be there with snow. Path and lift a spade of snow.
Snow, oh, to see a great big man entirely made of snow.
Snow,
where it's snowing open to blue, that's where I want to be.
Snowball throwing, that's what I'll do.
Now I'm longing to ski
through the snow. Twisting houses that seem to be built of snow.
Snow. You see a mountain covered with a quilt of snow.
What is Christmas without snow?
Christmas with no
snow. White Christmas with no snow.
I'll soon be there with snow.
It's gonna snow.
I'll wash my hair with snow.
It's gonna snow.
And with the spade of snow.
It's gonna snow. I'll build a man that's made of snow.
It's gonna snow. I'd like to stay up with you, but I recommend a little nap. Go back to sleep.
Go to sleep and dream.
Dear. Oh, Lordy. Washington, D.C.? Susie, excuse me, Susan, don't you have some homework you should be doing?
Okay, so I was wrong about the snow.
May I help you? No, you cannot have your deposit back. Yes, we have space. You can have any room in the inn you'd like, including mine.
Actually, we're not guests. For your entertainment.
Oh, well, your audience just left. Better chase them. They're moving fast.
Ah, Coco and shushing. Oh, I can shush somebody right now. Clean coal there. Oof, just what we need.
Wait a minute. I know that voice. You're Bob Wallace.
Aw, look at that. See how you've touched him.
Phil Davis. Wallace, Davis, Davis, Wallace. What the heck are you two doing in Pine Tree?
Bringing you the fabulous Haynes sisters. Just wait till you hear them warble.
Oh, well, I'm sorry we'll have to cancel on you girls. We'll pay for half of your salary, as long as you're willing to take most of it in postage stamps.
Well, I believe I can still catch a southbound express. It's a real pleasure, Miss Haynes.
Delighted, Mr. Scrooge.
Martha, where the devil is the mail?
Attention! General Waverly, sir.
At ease, man. I said at ease.
Yes, sir.
Captain, how are you?
I'm fine, General, but what are you doing up here in Vermont?
I happen to own this establishment. What's your excuse?
Well, we were just telling your wife.
No, anything but its wife. You just put 10 years on me.
This is Martha Watson, my concierge.
Concierge? Well, at least she doesn't call me sergeant anymore. You know, once you posted a sign, breakfast and calisthenics, 0600 hours. And in answer to your question, Your Majesty, they brought these gals up to sing for us for the holidays.
They're the sisters of Frankie Haynes, sir.
Freckle-faced Haynes. The dog-faced boy?
Frank would be delighted you remember him.
It's a real honor to meet you, General.
Hero.
I think I hear Susie coming. My granddaughter's visiting from California.
It's Susan, actually.
Yes, the smart one in the family.
The strongest one, too. What is that, a Gutenberg Bible?
I'm writing a report about the American Revolution, and New England is where America began, but I really just came for the snow.
Out of the mouth of you-know-who.
Don't make any personal calls. Martha listens at the switchboard.
I do not. I check for the connections. Anyway, I already told these girls we'd have to cancel.
Cancel? Why? We've got a stage back in the barn, haven't we? Something wrong, Captain?
No, sir. Just barn, sir.
You've got a stage, all right. But who are they going to sing to?
Well, we drafted these girls for the holidays, and we're going to pay them for the holidays.
That's very generous, but we don't want
Miss Haynes, we're going to have 2 feet of snow tonight and be full of it by tomorrow.
Is that the forecast?
No, it's pigheadedness. There's one thing the Army taught me, it's to always be positive, especially when I don't know what I'm talking about. Now, Martha, has the mail come? I'm expecting a letter from Washington.
Washington? No, I haven't seen any letter.
You mean this letter, Grandpa?
That's the one. Izzy boys may have noticed this innocent paying proposition yet. This letter's my ticket. I'm going back in the Army.
Yes. He misses the food. No, why don't I show you girls up to your room before Light Horse Harry here puts you on KP.
Au revoir, my little mountain flower.
This is what I call Christmas.
Anyway, I wrote my old pal Carlton and applied for active duty. Maybe a training command or a post overseas.
Could I read the letter for you, Grandpa?
Nice and clear, Susie.
Dear Hank. Why, you dirty old B-A-S-T...
Here, I'll read that. Thank you. Dear Hank, etc. I was very amused to get your letter. You must be turning into a real practical joker, applying for a post of your ripe age. Okay, well, the rest is about his family.
Doesn't the Army want you back, Grandpa?
No, not right now.
But you're a hero. You should write to the President and ask him.
Susie, that's a very good idea, and you can help me write that letter. Well, good to see you, boys. About face! Forward, march! To the left, to the left.
Poor old guy.
That bad, huh?
He sank everything into this place. Pensions, life savings. Just look at these bills. I haven't had the heart to show them to him. You know, the bank sent me a form letter that'll curl your hair. Pay up or you're out.
And he doesn't know about these?
Would you tell him?
When the war was over, John the Lord, for the G.I. Josephs who were in the war. But for generals, things were not so grand, and it's not so hard to understand.
What can you do with a general when he stops being a general? Oh, what can you do with a general who retires?
Who's got a job for a general when he stops being a general?
They all get a job, but a general no one hires.
He walks into an office and answers to an ad. He'll take the job that's offered. The pay is not too bad. They ask his last position. He answers with a bunch. I was a general. Then they ask him out to lunch.
And he has to meet the mob.
but he doesn't get the job.
Nobody thinks of assigning him when they've stopped whining and dining him.
It seems this country never has enjoyed so many one
and two
and three
and four-star generals unemployed.
Listen, Phil. I mean, the old man needs some customers. Well, we could work up a few.
You mean bribe the locals?
No, no. Well, why don't we try out our new show right up here in Vermont?
You know, if you had better legs and a personality, I'd marry you.
Gosh, a Wallace and Davis review, that would pack the place.
We'd have to talk to the girls. We're horning in on their gig.
We heard the whole thing. We think it's a great idea.
And I think so too.
Great, we can headline you two at the top of the second act. Have you got your charts for the band?
Coming right up.
You know, Mr. Wallace, there's this woman up here in town who used to be in show business. She sings, she dances.
Great, she can work backstage as a dresser. Meantime, I need long distance. I have to call New York.
Aye, aye, Captain.
That's Navy.
So court-martial me.
New York? What for?
Sheldrake. He's our contact for the 151st. Ralph's office sends out letters to all the guys. We get some of the division up here for Christmas, and we buck up the old man.
You know what I call that?
A $1 million proposition. We'll take the job of assigning him, then start whining and dining him, because this country never has enjoyed so many one
and two
and three
and four-star generals unemployed.
But we've got a job for a general who's retired.
Business like show, business like no, business on.
What are you doing?
Honey, you scared the life out of me.
Where did you get that silly hat?
Nowhere. Why don't you help me set up the barn for rehearsal?
But the barn is where I work on my history report.
The American Revolution will still be here tomorrow. Now come on, we got show folks coming any minute.
Grandpa says show business is
frivolous. Do you know what Patrick Henry said?
Give me liberty or give me death.
Do you know where he said it?
Where?
On the stage of the Winter Garden Theater. Class dismissed. Ezekiel! Ezekiel Foster!
Yep.
Open up the curtains.
Yep.
Who is he?
He came with the barn.
Well, it's a barn, all right.
Mr. Wallace, the barn is my classroom.
Do I smell a piano in this classroom? Oh, yes, I do. Oh, dear, this Steinway numero 5.
Mr. Davis, you can't really smell the piano.
Oh, yes, I can. I can detect a spinet at 50 feet.
Don't confuse the child.
You know, Mr. Wallace, this woman up here in town, she not only sings and dances.
Tell her to send us a picture. We'll certainly consider her.
I can't believe her performing in an actual barn.
You look better in a barn than most girls do in a Chanel gown.
Maybe it's all this clean, cold air.
Maybe it isn't only the clean, cold air.
Oh, really?
Yes, really.
Hello.
Hello.
They sure seem to be getting along.
Unlike us, you mean?
Oh, no, I didn't mean it. Yes, unlike us. But I thought you and I might...
Mr. Wallace, there's no need to be polite. Phil and Judy are.
Phil and Judy.
Mm-hmm. And you and I are?
Bob and Betty.
We're Bob and Betty, exactly. Sometimes the twain was not meant to meet.
Sometimes a twain doesn't ever leave the station.
All right, people, calm down. People, calm down, calm down. I've got rehearsal schedules for the chorus. I've got 3 sets of scene breakdowns. They're labeled A, B, and C. Let's pass them out.
Mike, relax. It's just a show.
Just a show. Mr. Wallace, do you realize you're attempting to stage a Broadway extravaganza in 5 days? 5 days! And that the stage manager's office is a pigsty, and I mean a real stop, with an actual pig.
We'll work him into the finale. Right now, I want you all to meet Betty and Judy Haynes. This is Mike Nolte, stage manager.
Hello.
Hello. Let's see.
Hi.
Scooter's on the keys. That's Gloria. And Jim.
Hi. Hello.
And Marty. Okay, you'll have plenty of time to meet them all up close.
Hiya, Philly.
Oh, Philly Dillio.
Hey, it's the Bobbsey twins.
It's a good thing I forgot my woolens, given how sultry it is up here.
As if it ain't hot enough with Philly Dilly around.
I mean, I was hot all the way up just thinking about you, Phil.
But it ain't the heat.
It's the humidity.
Pardon my innuendo, but who's she?
Sorry. Judy Haynes? Rita? Rhoda.
Rhoda Ritter. Hello.
Charmed, I'm sure.
As am I.
Oh, well, that makes 2 of us.
Okay, kids, we're doing the show Christmas Eve, and it's just around the corner, so we've got to hustle. Scooter, give me a chord.
Mi, re, ma, mo, mu. Mi, fe, fa, fo, fu. Ti, te, ta, to, tu.
Attend, hut!
What the devil is all this racket in here?
The Broadway Battalion, sir. Reporting for Christmas duty.
Captain Wallace, what are all these troops?
We call it a cast, sir. You see, the Haynes sisters gave us a spot in their act, and so we invited up a few volunteers.
The few volunteers. This is half the population of Vermont.
Show folks, you know?
No, I don't know. I don't know anything about show business.
That's because the last time you were at a show, it was lit by candles.
Captain Wallace, if you're worried about a certain innkeeper, we don't need any charity here.
Oh, this isn't a charity, sir. This is standard operating procedure.
Well, as I say, I don't know anything about show business.
That's all right, sir. We all have our talents. I'd have never been any good as a general.
You weren't any good as a private.
Yes, sir. Thank you, sir.
Well, I expect you all to follow regulation. Rules for the fire squad are posted. Police the barn and perimeter. Lights out at 2200 hours. Your command, Captain. Proceed.
Wow. No wonder we're winning the war with Germany.
Rhoda, we won the war with Germany.
Oh, good.
You know, Mr. Wallace, this woman up here in town, she was in the Walter Winchell column 15 times.
You keep her on call, Martha.
Sardis put a picture up in the ladies' room.
Maybe we can use her for the late show.
Ethel Merman once said to her in the wings, she said, honey, you are loud. You want to know how loud that woman was?
Well, how loud is that, Martha?
I'm glad you asked me, Senator. What care I who makes the laws of the nations? Let those who will take care of its rights and wrongs. What care I who cares for the world's affairs, as long as I can sing its popular songs.
I know that voice.
It's Martha the Megaphone Watson.
6 flops on the Great White Way.
Maybe you shot the show and whoop-de-doo.
Now stand back, Pine Tree. Watson's back in town. Let me sing funny song with crazy words that roll along. And if my song can start you laughing, I'm happy.
happy. Let me sing a sad refrain of broken hearts that loved in vain. And if my song can start you crying, I'm happy. Let me croon of low-down blues to lift you out of your seat. If my song can reach your shoes and start to dampen your feet, I'm happy. Let me think of Dixie's charms, the Swanee shores and mother's arms. And if my song can make you homesick, I'm happy.
Just give me a follow spot, that's all I ask. I'm like a sunflower, put a light on me and I turn. Hey Zeke, hit me with some purple floodlights. Ooh, I'm young again. Now drop me a show curtain that's gaudy as all get out. Voila! Now give me a red boa I can shimmy with. And I'm happy. Let me croon a blow down blues to lift you out of your seat. If my song can reach your shoes and start to dampen your feet, I'm happy. Let me sing Dixie's charms, the Swanee shores and mother's arms. And if my song can make you homesick, can start you laughing, can start you crying, I'm happy.
Bravo! Encore! Encore! Martha, where did you learn to do all that?
You don't learn that, sweetheart. You're born with it.
Can I be born with it?
Somebody get that woman a costume.
Costume? I want a 2-year contract.
Catch you later, Philly.
Bye.
Oh, Philly Dilly, oh.
Judy, those girls are my cousins. We went to kindergarten together.
All you kids are sleeping in the ski lodge.
Which was the ski lodge?
I'm glad you asked me, Senator.
Let me show you where that is.
Especially Pasadena. But remember to bless Grandpa most of all. I'll even give up snow, though frankly, I'd rather not. Amen.
Say there, Miss Susan. What are you doing up? It's the middle of the night.
It's all right, Mr. Wallace. I'm on Pacific time. I'm 3 hours behind.
And your grandfather will put you on standard military time if you don't get some shut-eye. Now, come on.
I haven't been sleeping so well in Vermont anyways.
What's the matter? You homesick? You got something on your mind?
No, nothing. Just the usual day-to-day concerns and stuff.
Those day-to-day concerns are killers, all right.
Mr. Wallace, is Grandpa really going back into the Army?
I don't know. He might sometime.
Could I go into the Army with him?
Well, you could volunteer, but you might be on the short side.
Mr. Wallace, is Grandpa very unhappy?
Yeah, Susan, I think he is.
I wish I could find a way to help him. Oh, I love him so much.
Well, you just tell him. Maybe that's all the help he needs.
I want to. I almost did today, but I'm kind of scared of him.
You don't need to worry about that. He's just scared 6,000 grown men at a time. Now, come on, let's go get some sleep.
But how can I? All I think about is Grandpa.
Why, it's simple. You try the Bob Wallace method.
When I'm worried and I can't sleep, I count my blessings instead of sheep, and I fall asleep counting my blessings. When my bankroll is getting small, I think of when I had none at all, and I fall asleep counting my blessings. I think of on a nursery, and I picture curly heads, and one by one I count them as they slumber in their beds. If you're worried and you can't sleep, just count your blessings instead of sheep, and you'll fall asleep counting your blessings.
Insomniac? Yeah, seems to be a whole club of us around here.
That was very beautiful, what you told her.
Well, I mean, it's just common sense is all.
You can't take a compliment, can you?
Nope, never could.
Bob, I think you staying up here and trying to help out the general, I think it's one of the most decent and unselfish things I've ever seen.
Well, you talk about decent and unselfish, try the old man. You know, I once saw him carry a man out of a burning Jeep running 50 yards under fire. I mean, I'm just a piker compared to that.
You don't really believe all that about angles and percentages, a little bit of larceny. You put up a good show, though.
Old habits, I guess. You see, the neighborhood I grew up in, larceny was the only thing going around. But then I went to the Army and, well, I found out different. I met guys like the General. You know, guys who put their lives on the line for you, no questions asked.
I found that in show business. Those kids who came up here today.
Bunch of big hearts, all right. Well, I better get some sleep if I can.
If I'm worried and I can't sleep, I count my blessings instead of sheep, and I fall asleep counting my blessings.
You're worried and you can't sleep, just count your blessings instead of sheep, and you'll fall asleep counting your blessings.
Good night, Bob.
See you around the mess hall.
Good morning, the Sullivan Show. Jose Jimenez. One second, Senor Jimenez. Good morning, the Sullivan Show. Miss Killigan. Sorry, he's on another line.
Let me get this straight, Mr. Banks. Your client, Topo Gigio, the lovable Italian mouse, refuses to go on after Slinky the Seal. Mr. Banks, may I remind you that Slinky the Seal juggles balls and catches fish and doesn't know a thing about comedy. Well, would he go on after Senor winces in his talking box? Okay. I'll talk to Topo, you talk to Slinky. We'll talk. Goodbye. Ethel?
Yes, Mr. Sheldrick.
Did you send out those letters to the guys in the 151st? by going up to this inn for Christmas?
Yes, sir.
You're a peach. Now, can you give me the Columbia Inn? I need Bob Wallace on the line.
Good morning, Columbia Inn. Yes, we have plenty of weather. Come up and see it. Good morning, Columbia Inn. Do we have entertainment? And if my son can make you... Hello? Hello? Good morning, Columbia Inn.
Morning, Captain Wallace.
This isn't Captain Wallace. This is Martha Watson.
Martha Washington?
Watson. Watson.
Oh, Martha Watson. I didn't think I was that old.
Neither did I.
Martha, this is Ralph Sheldrake in New York.
Oh?
Can you pass a message to Bob Wallace for me? Just tell him our secret scheme is going great.
Secret scheme?
About this inn up there, the Columbia Inn. Here's the deal. The whole company's ready to come up and take it over. Christmas Eve.
A company taking over the inn? But I don't understand.
The folks out there will never know what hit them. Say this to Bob, quote, "This is a million-dollar proposition."
$1 million? But Mr. Sheldrake...
Don't worry. Bob will know what I mean. And say, Martha, keep this on the QT, will you?
Yes, but Mr. Sheldrake...
Great, you're a peach.
Bob's got a company. Oh my gosh, he's scheming to buy up the inn.
No, again, from the top. 5, 6, 7, 8.
Can we fix this lighting? Can we please fix this lighting? People! Ezekiel Foster.
Yep.
Do you realize we are in a crisis?
yep.
Morning, Mike. Did you say something about a crisis?
Put up a show in 5 days. 5 days! Why not? They say God took a week.
Well, everything's faster now.
People!
Morning, sweetheart. Are we friends again?
I didn't know we ever stopped.
Oh, Billy Dilly!
But don't press your luck. We brought our costumes from the old show.
What do you think?
Girls, this is a completely different show.
We already thought of that. It's snow!
I'll go talk to Wardrobe.
Wardrobe, that way.
Morning. People!
Morning. Usually Friday this morning. You might say Santa came early this year.
If you're talking about Santa Bob Wallace, it couldn't have happened to a nicer girl.
We had a long talk last night, Judy. I didn't think they made guys like that anymore.
Oh, happy holidays, sister.
For you. From New York.
For me? Quite a day.
From the Imperial at the Regency Room. Stop. Can you come immediately? Stop. Solo engagement, you name the terms. Stop. Signed, what are you doing? We're the Regency Room.
What did you do? Hold it up to the light?
That's for amateurs. I use steam.
5 minutes, ladies. 5 minutes. People! 5!
Too bad you'd have to give a pine tree to take the job. Are you going to take the job?
What? And give up Pine Tree?
You're so honorable. Too bad not everybody around here is as honorable as you are.
Anybody in particular?
I shouldn't tell you this, but I got a call from a Mr. Sheldrick, a friend of Bob's. Betty, they're scheming up to buy the inn.
They're what?
Our secret scheme is going great, he says to me. It's a $1 million deal. And then he swears me to silence.
That's not possible.
They're not even going to warn the old coot. Just kick him in the drawers.
Bob cannot be involved in something like that.
If I'm wrong, I'll resign as president of the New England chapter of Busybody Anonymous.
Martha, Grandpa found all the bills you've been hiding. Is he angry?
Oh, Jupiter.
What are we going to do?
There's only one honorable thing to do. We gotta hide.
Can we fix this lighting? Ezekiel!
Morning, Miss Haynes. How'd you sleep last night? Well, I didn't get a wink myself. Yep, one of the best nights of my life. Hey, what's the matter?
You got a message from Mr. Sheldrick. Seems your secret scheme is working out.
Oh, beautiful, beautiful.
$1 million deal, huh?
$1 million proposition, yep. That's good old Ralphie. Say, how's this for a great little angle?
Brilliant.
This will really help out the old man.
Help him? Is that what you call it?
Why, sure, this will take the load right off him.
A little bit of larceny in all of us.
Oh, honey, this will put larceny out of business. Say, you'll keep this under your lid, won't you?
I cannot believe you'd have the gall to... Excuse me.
Now, what's all this, Betty?
Oh, don't let me interfere in the business plans of the great Bob Wallace, and I have a telegram to answer.
Now, Betty, if this is about last night...
I'd rather not discuss that.
It was just a little kiss. There's nothing to feel guilty about.
Look, he was talking about guilt!
Am I supposed to feel guilty about something?
Are we finished? Is that all, Mr. Wallace?
Yeah, that's all, Miss Haynes.
Martha! Where the devil is that woman?
Places! Is everyone in costume?
Paging Mr. Wallace. Your number, Mr. Wallace.
Phil, have you ever figured out women?
Yeah, they got long hair and they're smarter than we are. Next question.
Forget it. Listen, pal, we got the word from Ralph. Letters went out to the division to get some of the guys up here for Christmas. We are solid.
Great.
Okay, boys and girls, here we go. Now fix this lighting!
I was blue, just as blue as I could be. Every day was a cloudy day for me. Then good luck came a knocking at my door. Skies were gray, but they're not gray all the blue skies grow now.
nothing but blue skies. Do I see?
Thank you. have a contract here. I have to leave, Judy. I thought you'd understand. Without any explanation, it was something that was told to me in confidence. So you can't break in confidence, but you can go off and play the Regency Room? It's a big break. I'm glad you got it. But whatever happened to Miss Honesty's best policy? She run off and turned to Miss Lady or something? Honey, it just breaks my heart. But aren't you in love with Bob? I thought I was. What did he ever do to drive you off like this?
Let's just say Bob's not the man I thought he was.
What man ever is? Not my hopes of. Bob is the most decent guy on this planet. Unlike his partner.
Now what the devil is all this packing about? Good Lord, not even I'm talking like the old rooster.
It's about Bob and Betty, and maybe Phil and Judy too.
Well, that's what you get whenever you go along with the song and dance man. You get a song and a dance. I learned that from the 23 horn players I went out with. Scum. Every last one of them.
Well, Betty, I'd go with you. Except I'd like to stay here and tear Phil's head off.
Well, I say congratulations.
Congratulations?
This is America, sisters. Celebrate your freedom. The only thing you have to lose is your girls.
Crocodile tears will not be shed. They're not for a lady like I. I can recall what my aunt said when she married for the 20th time. Falling out of love can be fun when your love is over and done. It's an awful blow, but although it's upsetting, so much you can do while you're forgetting. Falling out of love can be fun. When you find your lover has gone,
when you find your lover has gone,
get your second wind and go on,
get your second wind and go.
It's an old affair that is there renewing
in your grief. Do you know what you're doing?
Falling out of love can be fun.
Your love is departed, but don't be broken hearted.
Soon you'll be swinging on an African board.
Swing and swing and swing. Love can give a lady a clout, and she may be down but not out. Get yourself a date, don't you wait till the count of ten. Then, falling out of love can be falling in love again. Soon you'll be losing all your troubles and your tears. One eye winking at someone.
Right now.
So he's demanding our presence now.
Isn't that just like a man?
Susan, would you go tell Bob to take a nice long walk off a high ski jump?
Okay.
When you find your love and romance, it's a sudden kick in the pants. Get yourself surrounded and bounded with lots of.
Title.
You know,
Yeah, well. We gotta set these lights for the girls, remember? The band goes off in 10 minutes. We don't do it now, we ain't gonna.
Say, do any of you girls know this routine or number?
No.
Well, partner, looks like we've got no choice.
Do you mean what I think you mean?
Uh-huh. Hey, Ezekiel, hit me with the number 17, surprise pink.
Oh, not the surprise pink.
Sister, sister, there were never such devoted sisters. Never had to have a chaperone, no sir. I'm here to keep my eye on her. Caring, sharing, every little thing that we are wearing. When a certain gentleman arrived from Rome, she wore the dress and I stayed home. All kinds of weather, we stick together, staying in the rain or sun. Two different faces, but in tight places, we think and react as one. Uh-huh. Those who've seen us know that not a thing can come between us. Many men have tried to split us up, but no one can.
Leave town? Everybody take five, please.
Well, I took the liberty of borrowing the wire. Here, have a look.
The Regency room? Huh. Well, I like that. Dump in Vermont for the big time. Hey, I said take five!
Captain, I think you're making a tactical error.
All the time I talk. What a lot of guff.
Bob. One of the jobs of a commanding officer is knowing how to assess people. In my assessment, Miss Haynes doesn't have an ounce of guff in her. She's in love with you, and you're in love with her. So if you don't go off and chase her, then you're a fool.
I think so too.
General, could you arrange a car to take me to New York?
It's already waiting outside.
Sister, you are a prize.
Wait till you hear me sing.
Later, Susie. Have a safe trip, buddy.
Good luck, son.
Manhattan's Imperial Hotel wishes you the happiest of holiday seasons. And now, your first solo New York engagement, Miss Elizabeth Haynes.
you no lie. How deep is the ocean? How high is the sky? How many times a day do I think of you? How many roses are sprinkled with dew? How far would I travel to be where you are? How far is the journey from here to a star?
Think you're underhanded, do you?
Underhanded? You talk about underhanded.
That's a pretty mysterious remark.
I'm so angry I can hardly speak to you.
Listen, Betty, if it's something I said or did, I'd like to set it right. I just need to know what it is.
If you don't know, I can't explain it.
Now I'm totally lost. Evening, Bob. It's a good thing I ran into you. Glad you can make it. Ralph, this is Betty Haynes. Betty Haynes, Ralph Sheldrake.
Mr. Sheldrake, I've heard a lot about you.
Wow, I'm sure glad Bob called me in to see your act. You are TNT, Miss Haynes.
You see, Ralph and I were in the Army together, and now he works for the Ed Sullivan Show.
The Ed Sullivan Show? I thought you were in real estate.
No, I'm only a humble TV producer. Anyway, I just talked to Ed about you, Miss Haynes. He wants to book you on the show. Now, how's that for $1 million proposition?
$1 million proposition?
The folks out there will never know what hit them. But look, Bob, I still haven't heard from half the guys. I think our letters got stuck in the holiday mail.
That's a tough break. Say, do you think Ed will give me a spot on his show tomorrow?
Sure, I can cut Kate Smith down to 3 courses of God Bless America.
I'm sorry, you're not in real estate?
No, no, I'm not.
And Bob, you called him in to see me even though I left your show?
You're good, that's all I know. Listen, if a solo act is what you want, then take it. But say, I gotta scram. Ralph, I'll see you at the office. And Betty, take care, and good luck.
Can you believe a star like Bob Wallace setting this up for the General? We must have sent out 600 letters trying to put it together.
Mr. Sheldrake, there's a few things you'll have to explain to me.
Whatever he wants to do.
wherever he wants to go. You see, we in the 151st used to sing that to General Henry Waverly, and I'm here with a call to the 151st. You see, the general could use some company nowadays. Now, I know it's asking a lot, going up to Vermont for vacation with your families, but the way I see it, I mean, that's what Christmas is all about. Some of us wouldn't be alive today if it weren't for the general, myself included. So we'd be giving just about the nicest gift we could to the greatest guy we will ever know. Because we love you, especially when he keeps us on the floor. And the velvet kitties we ask so duty for. He's the grandest son of a soldier of them all.
I cannot dance in these shoes.
Are you sure it's the shoes?
Is the gown ready?
You fix the gown.
Of course. Any word from Bob yet?
Not yet. He'll tell us that they left in the middle of the night.
Well, he's only got about 3 hours to showtime.
Holiday traffic. Happy Christmas Eve, folks.
Hey, what, Bob? Did you see Betty?
I saw her, all right.
Yes, and?
What happened?
She won't come back. I couldn't budge her. Anyway, how are things looking over here?
Oh, not too bad, not too bad.
What is that? I mean, I hope it's not obscene.
It's where the engagement ring is going to go. Right there.
Wow. Things sure happened fast in Vermont.
Yes, we're renaming it to the Sunshine State.
Well, that's terrific. Congratulations, you two.
Mr. Wallace, Mr. Davis, I've been working on my number.
All right, Susan, you beat us into submission. Show us your number.
Stand back, Pine Tree. Susan's back in town.
Let me sing a fun song with crazy words that roll along. Yeah, and if my song can start to laugh, then I'm happy. I'm like a sunflower. Put a light on me and I turn. Ezekiel, hit me with those footlights. Ooh, I'm young again. Now bring me a show curtain, this gaudy fall ghetto. Voila!
I demand 6 figures. No, 12 figures.
Martha! Oh, there's the old man. Don't forget it, Martha.
I know. Operation uniform.
Front and center, Miss Watson, I want to talk to you.
You know what your problem is, Grandpa? You need to learn to count your blessings instead of your sheep. And you'll be
cleaners.
All of them. On Christmas Eve.
You'll be fine. You'll wear your uniform tonight.
No. I will not wear my uniform.
Then you'll wear your undershorts and you'll be quite the picture. People won't be able to tell you from the Christmas tree stand.
You know, I got along very well in the army without you.
Yes, but it took 17,000 men to take my place and you're wearing your uniform tonight.
You know what you're acting like right now? You're acting like a wife.
Well, I've had enough practice. We argue all the time. We never go out. People think we are married.
Afternoon, General.
Ezekiel.
Martha.
Zeke.
Merry Christmas.
And God bless us, blah, blah, blah.
Been here and out all day. Got a letter for you. Mr. Wallace. A letter for you, sir.
We haven't got all day to see you.
From, Washington.
From Washington?
From the White House. So right there in the corner. Anyway, wind's picking up. Better light a fire tonight. Happy holidays.
Bah humbug.
Been hearing a lot of that, too. See ya.
Good lord.
What? The Pentagon found out about that tank you stole?
They want me back. The president pulled the strings. I've been posted to Europe and can ship out after the holidays.
Oh, Henry. Henry, I'm so glad, really.
You're not gonna go cry on me, are you?
What? No, that's just my astigmatism acting up. And see, you can wear your uniform tonight.
Well, I don't know where all the medals are.
I'll find them. You're absolutely hopeless, I swear.
I thought I'd never see you again. Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas, Bob.
everybody. It's magic time, people! Prices for the top of the show! Prices!
$0600. Well, from now on, it'll be breakfast all day and waffles all night. Beds will not be made. Calisthenics are strictly forbidden. And anybody who calls me sir instead of hang shall be thrown out on his can. You see, I know something today that I didn't know yesterday. If you are worried and cannot sleep, just count your blessings instead of sheep. And you will fall asleep, counting your blessings. The last time I saw your faces, you were all boys. Now seeing you here with your wives and children, it's a grand sight. Soldiers, from the bottom of my heart, Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas, sir!
What was that?
Merry Christmas, Hank!
What was that?
Merry Christmas, Hank!
Dismissed! Or as they say in the theater, on with the show.
Maestro, once more from the top, please.